Good afternoon and welcome, and thank you for joining our Mars 2020 landing coverage. I'm David Denault, and we'll be joined by Rick Potluck from our Washington Bureau and Don Meyer from the Florida Space Coast. But first, we are within minutes of NASA's Mars rover entering its new planetary home. The spacecraft has begun its approach to the red planet, and Perseverance will blaze through the atmosphere at 12,100 miles an hour, and then gently touch down in the Jezero crater about 7 minutes later. We will be for the first time to see and hear our spacecraft land on another planet. About Space Today, we'll join NASA's live coverage of the landing just moments from now. But first, here is what we would expect to see and take place. Well, Rick, this will also be a first time for a spacecraft that has its own landing system.
Yes, it is, David. Because there's an 11-minute delay in communication between Earth and Mars, mm-hmm. the rover, actually the whole system, has to have its own landing and communication system because of that delay. But this will also be the first time that we're going to get a chance to not only see the landing on Mars, but also hear it. There are 19 onboard cameras from every conceivable angle so that we can possibly see what's going to transpire once it gets into the Mars atmosphere in that what they call the 7 minutes of sheer terror between the time the rover's going to go from 12,000 miles per hour down to 1.2 miles per hour to gently touch down on the Martian surface. Back to you, David.
Thank you. Don, the last few weeks, you have been leading the stories here on the historic landing and reported a lot of different things that is on board the rover. And what stands out to you the most?
Well, I would say what really stands out to me is the fact that we've got these samples that we're actually going to be bringing back to Earth. Now, granted, that won't be for 10 years, maybe, possibly, but it's still just a phenomenal thing to be having these come back without a person necessarily bringing them back. Mm-hmm. And also the fact that they're going to have that helicopter. That helicopter just amazes me that we're going to see if you can actually fly in what little atmosphere Mars has. Is just a phenomenal thought for me.
Well, Rick, to you stands out the most?
Well, the whole mission itself, David, the fact that, number one, they're going to come up with 40 cigar size samples that they're going to pack up. They're going to keep it in what I would consider to be sterile environments, probably for 10 to 15 years. They're going to have four spacecraft and four robots pack everything together and then send it back to Earth. And the scientists that are going to be exploring and working with these samples probably aren't even in college yet. They may be in middle school right now. So this is the part of the mission that really intrigues me the most, is some middle school kid right now will be the scientist that will be working with these samples that are going to be coming back to Earth from Mars that are being gathered in the next several months.
Well, Don, you are a veteran of the space program. You had a 28-year run with the space shuttle program and was there for the rover launch almost a year ago. It took about, 200 and some odd days for it to launch and then reach the Martian planet. As you go back and think about some of these things, I asked 200 days to fly this mission. Talk a little bit about some of the mechanics that you look at when you're preparing your reports and what makes us so different than the other Mars explorers.
Well, of course, the other Mars explorers were just things that were going to do limited experiments and do a lot of driving. So I found that quite interesting. This one is a larger rover. It's like a size of a small SUV. And I think Rick said something like it was a Yugo, and I'm trying to remember what a Yugo looked like.
How about a Volkswagen?
Okay, a Volkswagen. There you okay. go. So that's much larger than the other ones. And you can see there in the background of my picture here, that is a picture of the Perseverance rover. So you can see it's got a lot of stuff on it. Like Rick said, it has all those different cameras on it. It's going to be able to, you know, it's going to be lowered down as some of the other Martian rovers were from the lander and just kind of gently set down, and then that lander leaves. And it's got so much science it's going to do. Just like I said, it just fascinates me that it's going to start collecting those little tubes of samples and hanging on to them until whatever it is, it's going to be able to come and get them. And then like the picture that you've got up there, it's got that helicopter. And that helicopter is going to be able to fly for about, are we going to switch over the parachute deployed?
Okay, we have, do we have a video yet from them?
What we have is a still picture and some telemetry that's coming in from NASA, David.
Okay.
But the NASA did get confirmation that the first parachute has deployed and they are heading toward landing. We All have right. not received any video yet, though.
Gotcha. Okay, so they have a graphic up for us right now. Let's take a look at that graphic if we can.
They just switched over to mission control.
Okay.
Oh, there's the graphic. There we go.
Oh, okay. One of the things that makes this really unique, we were talking about the samples when they come back to Earth, Rick. We have a slide of the rover, a full-size slide of the rover. Let's take a look at that and talk a little bit now the collection system. Dawn, you did a very interesting story this past Tuesday about how scientific they've been in the cleanliness that they've had to have involved.
Well, because they need to make sure that anything that's in those samples isn't from Earth, that it didn't go with them, or that they've collected as, of course, it was getting there or landing. And so just the fact that they have had to completely redo how the tubes were made and how much, that sounds like they're doing a lot more of the landing stuff now.
Yes, they are.
Okay, we still don't have any video coming in quite yet, though.
Other than, but we've got audio.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah, they're 0.6 of a mile off the surface right now.
Okay, back shell separated.
All right, let's take, can we go to NASA? Let's take a look at what their simulation is doing right now.
Let's go with their audio also.
Okay.
And of course they went silent. Here we go.
Constant velocity accordion altitude. We have started our constant velocity accordion, which means we are conducting the sky crane, about to conduct the sky crane maneuver.
We've lost direct to earth tones.
Throttle down. Sky crane maneuver has started. About 20 meters.
Tango Delta. Nominal. We're getting signals from MRO.
Remu stable.
UHF is good. Touchdown confirmed. Perseverance safely on the surface of Mars. Ready to begin seeking the sands of past life.
Touchdown confirmed.
Yay! Woohoo!
Well, the cameras didn't work, but they got the telemetry and the information that says they did touchdown. That's great. Very good. Congratulations to all concerned. Mm-hmm. At 3:56 or so, touchdown.
Very cool. Very cool. That's just amazing.
It is. It really is amazing. We can come back, talk a little. They're still seeing getting some telemetry there. We can come back. We'll chat a little bit more, and maybe there'll be wait for the images is what they're saying right now.
Right.
And so while we wait for those images, About Space Today will return after these commercial messages. Is your group flying into Orlando? BTM Coaches is your transportation provider with special meet and greet services. BTM Coaches has Central Florida's industry-leading motor coaches with superior comfort. Whether your group is coming for a cruise holiday, a visit to the beaches, or coming to visit our theme parks, BTM Coaches provide safe and professional transportation for all types of groups, small or large. BTM Coaches are the most modern, reliable, and fully equipped with all of the modern conveniences. And we have tour packages for cruise guests and for those who want to come and see space launches. Come see Orlando, the Space Coast, and the beaches. Call or email DND Cruise and Tours at 877-747-8631. That's 877-747-8631. And come see the Space Coast. Are you ready to fly away on a dream vacation? For cruises and all-inclusive resort vacations, call D&D Cruise and Tours at 877-747-8631. That's 877-747-8631. And see us on Facebook, D&D Cruise and Tours, where your dreams become a reality. The Space Coast is calling. So come on down to the Best Western on Cocoa Beach. Now stay three and pay for two on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday nights. And attend a live televised broadcast of About Space Today with special guests, including astronauts, on Friday mornings. Come to the Best Western on Cocoa Beach for a pre-cruise stay or for a launch. Plus, a one-day Kennedy Space Center ticket is included along with your full breakfast and all amenities at the hotel. Here's General Manager Jamie Trejo.
The best part of hospitality is the people. And the comments that we get, whether it's about, you know, the fire pit or the pool area or about the beaches, the ones that resonate and the ones that mean the most to me are the comments about the staff and the interactions and the engagement they've had with either myself or a member of our breakfast team or someone at the front desk. So when a guest leaves here and they leave with that positive emotion and that memory, that's what, you know, our business is really about.
For more details, call D&D Cruise and Tours at 877-747-8631. That's 877-747-8631. And come on down to the Space Coast. Welcome back. I'm David Denault, and we're joined right now with some of the videos that are coming in from the Mars lander. We're looking at Jet Propulsion Laboratory in California. They were responsible for putting this bird up and landing it on the surface of Mars successfully. I'm just wondering, you know, what I think would really capture the imagination, and I know it's not going to be today or tomorrow, but the viewers, I think, are going to really be impressed when they see this helicopter fly. How big is the helicopter, you think, and how long can it fly?
So the helicopter is about 5.5 feet, and it can fly up to 90 seconds, and it's going to go about a distance of 980 feet, which is 300 meters for those of you who like meters. Sure. And it's about 10 to 15 feet based on their estimates of simulating the Martian atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, the Martian atmosphere is only about 0.6% of the standard atmosphere of the Earth. And there's only about 60% of the gravity. So they've done their best to simulate that. And based on that, that's what they're expecting for the helicopter to do. So we'll see how that actually goes. And I'm really anxious to see that because it just amazes me that we can do it. And what transition to surface? I missed that.
Yes.
And so they're having lots of fun there at Mission Control. It's just clapping it.
I think we're waiting for the cigars to come out.
Uh-huh.
There you go.
Indeed. Well,
and what is it they were eating before? Peanuts? Wasn't that a tradition that they ate?
That's peanuts. An old tradition as well.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, so the Mars helicopter isn't necessarily going to start right away, like you said. They have an estimate based on how things go and how the checkout goes that it will start flying sometime between March 19th and May 19th. So, you know, we've got a little bit of time here. And so I'm really looking forward to it, though, and I think it'll be exciting.
Well, let's we've got the Mars lander. We're still waiting on some video to take a look at, but let's maybe some last comments here as we can conclude our coverage of the Mars historic landing. Beside the words wow in describing this landing to all three of us here, I'm just wondering what you would describe maybe in one word to the whole crew here.
Well, for me, I would say that it's just a phenomenal thing to have gotten to see. It's the next best thing to being there. You know, if I can't be on Mars, at least I can watch it from here. And just the thought of all the science they're going to get to do. I watched a couple of the Martian movies the other weekend, and you know, it was a lot of fun. And I said, oh, and we're going to be there in a couple of weeks. And my husband said, uh-huh. So, but I think that, and beyond, you know, the word wow, it's just amazing.
Rick, give me one word. How would you describe it?
Discovery, I think, is the apropos word. Because of all of the science that's going to take place, discovery is a good word. The other thing that is interesting, because of all of the cold weather that's happening back here on Earth, would you believe that in Minot, North Dakota, and in Mount Washington, in what is it, Vermont, or I'm sorry, New Hampshire, it's actually colder there than it is on Mars right now. On Mars, it's a nice warm 3 degrees. Of course, tonight it'll be minus 99. That's the latest weather forecast on Mars. But we wish all the folks on Earth to kind of warm up a little bit. But I think the discovery is going to be immense. And in my podcast for tomorrow on America in Space, you're going to hear from Ken Farley, who's from Caltech, and he's going to talk about some of the science that's involved in Perseverance and in Ingenuity. And he'll be talking about that tomorrow, David. But the other thing that I think we ought to leave people with is, in the coming days and months, you're going to hear people talking about Percy. And you're going to think, what are they talking about? Well, that's the nickname that the folks at NASA have given Perseverance. They call it Percy, and also they're going to refer to it as a she. So Perseverance has become Percy, and it's a she.
All right. Listen, thank you for doing a great job on our podcast and our live coverage today. And we appreciate that. Now, to our many viewers around the globe and in the U.S., thank you for listening to our coverage of the Mars 2020 rover landing. And join me next week on next Tuesday for About Space, and then Rick Ponlock tomorrow on America in Space. And be sure to tell your family and friends to listen to our podcast and join us as we continue America's role in space. I'm David Denault, and this has been About Space Today.
This has been a special report from About Space Today.